And joining us now here is Jane Kim. Thank you for coming in. We're going to pretty much ask you the same questions that we've asked all the other candidates. Let's start with homelessness. I grew up in the Bay Area. I don't think I've ever seen it this bad. There are homeless encampments everywhere, including throughout the city. Mm-hmm. Mayor Mark Farrell has said essentially enough is enough, and he's working to clear out those encampments. Do you support what he is trying to do? And if not, what would you do differently to deal with the homeless problem?
Well, I support getting people off the streets. I think the big question is always, where are they going? So if we're sweeping them from one corner to another corner, or one neighborhood from another neighborhood, we're not actually solving the problem. And what I've often seen with sweeps in the district that I represent is that one set of constituents will call and complain one day, and then the next day, a different set of neighbors will call and complain about the same encampment the next day. We simply have to build more shelter beds. But I have to say, this is a statewide crisis. The state of California has 20% of the nation's homeless count. We need the governor and the state legislator to act and join San Francisco and LA and San Diego in addressing the statewide issue.
Let's talk about affordable housing. That's one of the big issues. It feels in some cases like San Francisco is almost turning into a have and haves not. Mm-hmm. There's very little in the middle anymore. And all you need to do is drive down Mission Street and you see old, and then bam, this big new apartment complex or condo complex and expensive restaurants. What specifically would you do to address the affordable housing crisis in the city?
Well, it's a mixture of two strategies. One, we do have to build more housing, but in particular, we need to build more affordable and middle-income housing. San Francisco is just simply not building enough for families of four that make $150,000.
Which at one point would have sounded like a ton of money.
You know, I never thought when I got on the Board of Supervisors that I would be fighting to subsidize housing for families that make between $80,000 and $150,000, mm-hmm. but that is now part of my negotiations, and I'm proud of the fact that I have negotiated one more affordable and middle-income housing than any city legislator in the last 7 years. So part of it is expecting our developers to do their part in building for our residents while building luxury and market-rate housing in San Francisco. And the other part is in supporting and protecting tenants in our city. We have seen an overwhelming number of tenants, particularly seniors and immigrants, that get targeted for evictions, and we need to keep them in place in their homes, because if they don't, you know, some of them actually end up on our streets.
Let's talk about immigration. The illegal immigration is such a huge issue all across the country, but also in San Francisco, particularly with the sanctuary city policies. Mm-hmm. President Trump is dead set against those policies. What are your thoughts on being a sanctuary city?
Well, I'm proud that San Francisco is a sanctuary city. We welcome all of our residents and want to make sure that they feel safe living in our neighborhoods, but also reporting to the police and signing up for services. We don't think that it helps our local jurisdiction to tell our residents that they're not welcome in our city. We want to make sure that everyone participates in Sanctuary City is an important part of that.
Let's talk finally here about crime, and in particular, one of the things that I always think about are car break-ins. Mm-hmm. I think there were somewhere in the neighborhood of 27,000 car break-ins in San Francisco last year. That number is just phenomenal. It works out to about 80, 85 a day. Mm-hmm. And I have to be honest here, I live in Oakland, and I'm sure I'm not alone in this. There are times when I think, I could go into the city, but you know what? I just don't want to risk it. I don't want to park my car on the street mm-hmm. and come back and find my window broken and my car looted. I've talked to too many people where that has happened. What can you do and what would you do to stop that?
Yeah, it's not okay, the level of nonviolent property crimes that we're seeing here in San Francisco. And by the way, we have had a 17% reduction.
Right.
First mm-hmm. quarter, but we have plenty of more work to do. One of the things that I've called for is a dedicated district attorney's unit that just prosecutes auto burglaries. So right now, if you're a DA, you'll get everything ranging from homicides all the way down to auto burglaries. So, you know, what cases are you going to drop? You're going to drop the lowest level prosecutions, and actually that's the right choice. But if we even had two or three DAs that just focused on auto burglaries and also got a sense of the overall pattern of what's happening in the city, I think that we could take care of the issue. And my guess is, and the police have said this as well, a small group of people are doing the majority of the auto burglary break-ins.
Before we go here, I was reading your bio. Very impressive. Stanford undergrad, Cal grad at Bolt Hall, also a black belt in Taekwondo. I just think these are always interesting questions. Tell people something that they don't know about Jane Kim.
Oh, gosh.
Don't be bashful.
People, you asked me before the show started if I rooted for Stanford or for Cal, and I do root for my undergraduate team, although I really appreciated my law school experience at UC Berkeley. I have a black belt in Taekwondo, and I love food, and I love my city.
Well, that's all good stuff. And Jane, thank you for taking the time to join with us. Good luck. The election coming up on June 5th in San Francisco.
Thank
you. Appreciate your time.